Hi, students. Sorry I couldn't be in class with you today, but you still have work to do. So please go to your book on page 315, and I'm going to just very briefly show you our lesson for today. So today's lesson, we're looking at problem solving, and our strategy is determining if you need to estimate or give an exact answer. Mrs. Trainer needs to purchase a classroom response clicker and a new calculator. A clicker costs $31.99 and a calculator costs $11.75. About how much money will it cost to buy both? So let's use our UPS check strategy. The U stands for understand the problem. So we ask ourselves, what facts do we know and what do we need to find? So when I go back and reread my problem for a second time, I want to look for facts that I need for my problem. Well, a new clicker costs $31.99. So she needs to buy a clicker for $31.99. And a calculator costs $11.75. So what do I need to find? That's usually the question with the sentence with the question mark. It's usually at the end, but not all the time. But I need to find about how much money will it cost to buy both. So what do I need to find? About how much it will cost to buy both the clicker and the calculator. All right, I'm going to come up with a plan. Since my question asks for about how much money it costs, I can estimate the cost of the clicker and calculator. So I do not need to find an exact answer. Let's solve the problem. I'm going to round the costs to the nearest whole dollar. Sorry. There we go. $31.99 is really close to $32. It's just a penny away. And $11.75 is really close to $12. So to find the total cost, I can add together those rounded amounts. 32 plus 12 is $44. So Mrs. Trainer will need to spend about $44 for the two items. I can check my answer by estimating in a different way. So we could have rounded the amounts to the nearest tens place instead of the nearest dollar or whole. So $31.99 is also close to $30. And $11.75 is also close to $10. So another estimate can be $40. 44 is close to 40. So our answer is reasonable. So for today's lesson, you're going to need to determine if you have to estimate or find an exact answer. Keep in mind, when you're estimating, you'll usually see the word about. But read carefully because it might not always be there. The directions might also say find an estimate or to round. So be careful with your reading. Kiddos, you're now going to go to page 317 and work on those problems, and we will check it later on. All right, have a great rest of your day, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.